and had a huge kind of like open bass kind of looking mouth and didn't look like anything I'd heard of or seen before.
New at 7, a massive fish washed up in Cape Coral. If you think it looks like it doesn't belong here, it definitely doesn't. FWC says this is an Amazonian monster known as Arapaima. Look at this. This is a smaller picture, but the fish is actually 5.5 feet long. It's invasive, so if more of these river monsters start filling our waters, our ecosystem will be in danger. ABC 7's Alex Howard is getting us more on how this foreign fish ended up in the Cape.
The woman who first noticed the fish saw it floating in the water along the Caloosahatchee River here at JC Park in Cape Coral, but it wasn't until she snapped a photo of it with her phone and posted it to Facebook that someone was able to identify it as an arapaima.
It was bigger than my 7-year-old, who's not a small kid. I was like, that's nothing I've seen before. It was kind of white with a little pinkish tail.
Leah Goetz still remembers when her son pointed out this floating dead fish in the river while on a Saturday picnic.
And had a huge, kind of like open bass kind of looking mouth and didn't look like anything I'd heard of or seen before, so.
The floating carcass still had a fish hook in its mouth, resembling nothing she'd ever seen. And it wasn't long before social media sleuths figured it out.
And they were saying it was an arapaima, I think I pronounce it. And I looked at the pictures and it was dead on.
But that answer only brought more questions, like how a 5.5 foot long Amazon predator ended up in the Caloosahatchee River.
Considering what's already here and established in Florida, nothing really surprises me too much anymore.
John Cassani is an ecologist for the Caloosa Waterkeeper and worries that this carcass could mean there are more. He says as South Florida's climate warms, the zones in which arapaima can live continue to creep north, despite an FWC risk study saying our waters are too cold.
This risk study done on arapaima was done, I'm thinking, close to 10 years ago.
Opening the door for this aggressive, dangerous fish to wreak havoc on Florida's freshwater ecosystems.
Well, obviously a big, aggressive, predatory fish is popular amongst anglers. But again, the risk to the ecosystem is far outweighs the recreational value of these species.
In Cape Coral, Alex Howard, ABC 7.